All right, friends. So having seen the theory part now, it's time to solve some problems because this is the only way you learn mathematics. So let's start. First question says, find the measure of an angle which forms a pair of supplementary angles with itself. Okay. So you have to find, obviously you have to find something. This is a question. So you have to find something out. Measure of. So you have to find what? Measure of an what? Angle. Okay. So that means you have to find an angle X. So that's how we start. X forms a pair of supplementary angle with itself. Okay, so that means X is doing something with itself and it is forming a pair of supplementary angles. So what is it doing basically? So that means we know sum of two angles is 180 degrees and they are called supplementary angles. So X with itself is forming supplementary angles. That means X plus X must be equal to 180 degrees. So that means 2X is equal to 180 degrees. So what is X, guys? X is 90 degrees. So remember, learning. What's the learning? Learning is a right angle. Right angle is supplementary to itself. Right? Supplement of itself. Or rather, we write supplement of itself. Why? Because if you add right angle to a right angle, we'll get 180 degrees. Understood? That's how you solve the problem. Next, let's go to second problem. Now, this problem says two supplementary angles differ by 34 degrees. Find the angles. Okay, so information, let's mine the data. It says two supplementary angles. So there are two angles. Okay, two angles. So we start with this itself. Let the angles be theta and phi. If you are not comfortable with theta and phi, you can say x and y. So let us take x and y only instead of theta and phi because you guys are more comfortable, I believe, in let's say x and y. Now, mind you, x and y are the angle measures, not the angle itself. Okay. Now what? They differ by 34 degrees. Okay. So they differ means x minus y is 34 degrees. That's what they are saying. And now you have to find out the angles. So there could be lots of possibilities. Okay, so what could be x and y? So x is 35. Let's say x is 35 and y is 1. So you see, what is the x minus y? X minus y will be 34. So will this be solution? Can you say that x is 35 and y is 1? Or for that matter, 36 and 2. This is also 34. Or 37 and 3. This is also 34. So in all the cases, you are getting 34. So which one will you take up? Obviously, there is one more information, and that is the angles are supplementary. What did we learn? So supplementary means x plus y is 180 degrees. So this also has to be satisfied. Now, unfortunately, 35 plus 1 is 36. So if you see x plus y, is it working? It is 36. It is 38. I'm sorry. Yeah, 38. And this is 40. So none of them are working. So hence you have to keep on doing to get x plus y is 180. But then we also have another smart ways of solving this. What you do is add both of them, both these equations. Yep. So adding equation means add LHS to LHS, RHS to RHS. What will you get? You will get x minus y plus x plus y is equal to 34 plus 180. Okay. Now, if you know how to solve a pair of linear equation, nothing like it. Otherwise, you can substitute also. So, hence, you hear y gets cancelled. So, you get 2x is equal to 214. 180 plus 34 is 214. So, x, my dear friends, what is x then? So, x is 214 by 2. So, hence, it is 107 degrees. Isn't it? 107 degrees. So, what will be the other angle, you can use any of these equations. So hence x is 107. So deploy 107 minus y is 34. So what is y? Y will be 107 minus 34 degrees, which is equal to 73 degrees. Isn't it? And have we got the right answer? We can check. So the other equation was x plus y. Other equation was x plus y is equal to 180 degrees. Let's check whether it is satisfying or not. So x was, now what was x? X was 107. So 107 degrees plus y. What was y? 73 degrees. Add them up. You will get 180 degrees. So that means our result is correct. So x is 73, x is 107 and y is 73. So we got the results correctly. So this is how you have to solve these kind of problems.